months. The incarceration of 8 months. I won't forget. I will talk. I am mentally exhausted, emotionally drained, physically sick. I just want to go home, hug my mother, sleep. I really miss my family.
An incident of the intervening night of August 10 and 11, 2017, rocked at BRD Hospital in Gorakhpur, rocked the entire city, in fact, the entire country. A doctor who is a pediatrician was first lauded for saving so many child who were dying allegedly because of lack of oxygen, but after that he was jailed, and we are talking about none other than Dr. Kafeel Ahmad, who walked out of jail this evening, and we are joined by him. Dr. Kafeel, thanks very much for sparing time for talking to us. My first question to you, sir, is please share your experience in jail.
Jail is jail, and Gorakhpur is that barrack we were residing is really pathetic. The capacity is 60% used to have, and we used to have 150 people. The same barrack with one toilet, and we used to have to sleep on the floor. And you know, in Gorakhpur there total capacity is 800, and right now there are 2,000, more than 2,000 prisoners are there. Most of them are on trial, and actually 90% on trial. Very old. I don't know why government are not giving bail to them, or they're just shooting the number. I don't know. I have already written in a letter now that we have to sleep with millions of mosquitoes and thousands of fly, bath in front of, like, I have never done that. Since people do that, but I have never done that, bathing naked in the field. And then, you know, but time goes. Every day was like, you know, decades. And I used to just wait for the Sunday, Tuesdays and Thursday to meet my family. So jail is pathetic. It is that, you know, jail is jail. Even Yogi ji has said, na, that jail is jail. So jail is jail.
Can you describe what actually happened that fateful night of 2017?
There are so many things have already, you know. I don't have to go into the detail. It was on 9th Yogi ji came, so we were just preparing for 9th of August when he was supposed to inaugurate that high dependency unit on 9th of August 2017. So we worked for 7 days continuously, and you know, to start that high dependency unit. And then when he left on 9th, we were very tired. So I just asked my HOD for leave, and she said, okay, for one day I can give you. I said, okay, ma'am, I just want one day rest. I left. 10th, I was at home all the day, and then suddenly, you know, around 12:26, I think, that was the time I exactly remember, one of my senior resident, he messaged, we have a AES core group, he messaged that, there is no liquid oxygen and this is a crisis. So I just ran, and we did everything what humanly possible. Okay, we arranged cylinders from nearby hospitals. We asked everyone, all the gas agencies, fellow. Actually, by 1:30, 50 cylinder arrived from Faizabad, IGL, Imperial Gas Limited, Faizabad, who was supposedly, he has to deliver around 250 cylinders, but he's delivered only 50. But by the time, like 1:30, 2 o'clock, they reached, and that was sufficient till morning. Then morning again the same problem occurred. So we have to run and we have to search for the cylinders. When it was not enough, I ran to DIG SSB, asked them for their help. We went to each and every corner of BRD to get a empty cylinder. And we gathered so many people to carry it and put it in a truck. And then we went to all the gas, Modi gas agency actually, he helped. And we got around 120 cylinder in one truck. So around 250 cylinder per day we used. So see, whatever I did, it was not something heroic thing. I always said, I'm not a hero. Whatever it is, because anybody would have done the same thing, you know, because kids were dying, you know. I am also a father. My daughter was that time 11 month, and whenever I remember one girl, 3 year old, that was around morning 9:30, and that oxygen was not there, and we put her on Ambu bag, and she started, you know, when we did Ambu, she started bleeding. She started bleeding from nose, the whole ET tube, what we put on the throat, she started bleeding with that, and we tried hard to resuscitate her, but she died. And the parents, they started screaming and crying, and we also cried.
Sir, what actually went wrong? You were not either, though you were associated with the pediatrics department of the hospital because you are a pediatrician. Secondly, you were not in charge of the AES ward, acute encephalitis syndrome ward, 100-bed ward. You were just posted as nodal officer of National Health Mission.
Yes, NRH,
Then you went extra mile, as you are saying. You arranged cylinders. Then suddenly what went wrong? Why you were sent to jail?
Why? First question you ask, why this happened? So it's happened because the system is like that. You have to improve the system, you know. Pushpa Shale Limited, he has written numerous letters, at least 14 I remember. He has written to HOD Pediatrics, he has written to Principal, he has written to DM Gorakhpur, he has written to Principal Secretary, he has written to DGME Health and Education, he has written to Health Minister. But what all they did just forward to, like DM, when he got that letter, he said forward to CMO Gorakhpur. CMO, when he got the letter, forwarded to Principal BRD, you know. That was the thing they were doing. They just forwarding, you know. Even in our charge sheet, when I read that, in the investigation officer, when asked the DGME Health and Education about his responsibility and what he did when he got those reminders, he said, "I forwarded to FC." So that's the way this system works.
What is this FC?
Financial commissioner or something. So. He should have acted, he should have called, he should have said that no, send the money. They are saying I have sent the money on 5th. I am asking why you didn't send in April, why you didn't send in June, why you didn't send in July. You getting my point? So that's the way they were working. And then, you know, that thing happened. Lower level also, that the central pipeline operators, they did something, I don't know, maybe it's some big conspiracy. They informed on 3rd of August that oxygen is less, and then they forgot. They should have informed when the oxygen, liquid oxygen, goes down to below 14,000 units. They informed when it was 900, and they informed only on 10th. You got? So they should have informed on 7th or 8th. Yogi ji was coming, maybe we would have informed Yogi ji that there is the problem with this. Maybe principal would have informed Yogi ji that there is a problem with finance, and he would have arranged it itself. The problem would have not occurred. You getting my point? So this is the way the system works, and I think system has to improve. The higher authority, the way they shed their responsibility is not that. I remember principal was saying, I didn't know that, but in the jail he was telling me, on 3rd of August when he got the legal notice from Pushpa Cell that he is going to stop liquid oxygen within 15 days, they had a video conferencing where principal secretary Dr. Anita Jain Bhatnagar was sitting that side, and this side DM and principal was sitting, and they talk about how he is threatening, Manish Bhandari is threatening to stop the oxygen, liquid oxygen fund is not there. So I don't know what happened between them after that, but everybody knows. They said that we didn't know. They just said they were like, oh, I don't know. And even आम जनता भी जानती है ना कि डॉक्टर का काम ऑक्सीजन खरीदना नहीं है ऑक्सीजन खरीद आई वॉज नॉट इन्वॉल्व विद पेमेंट आई वॉज नॉट इन्वॉल्व विद टेंडर आई वॉज नॉट इन्वॉल्व विद ऑर्डर आई वॉज नॉट इन्वॉल्व विद सप्लाई ऑफ ऑक्सीजन आई डिड बिकॉज किड्स वर डाइंग बिकॉज आई एम अ फादर बिकॉज एनीबडी वुड हैव डन यू नो
वन रियलिटी इन दिस केस सो मेनी इनोसेंट लाइव्स वर लॉस्ट because of someone's negligence, be it the doctors, the management of the hospital, or the government of the day. Who should be held responsible for that?
There was sudden increase in the number of death on 10th night, 11th and 12th. This is the bigger truth. Who is responsible? I have already written you a letter I have written from jail. Who is responsible? And I am not an inquiry head that I should go and, you know, blame anyone. But I have already said that these people, the higher authorities, those who are sitting in Lucknow, they should think. And I think any proper investigation would go. They have not done the investigation properly. You know, investigation officer also, when he asked DGME, isn't your responsibility that you should have acted instead of just forwarding the letter? And he what did he answer? He just kept quiet. So I'm not going to blame anyone, you know, because I'm already in so much mess.
You are free now. You are in depression.
I don't know.
You are in depression, which is visible.
I'm scared that maybe some more charges will put and I will be behind the bar again. Who knows? If they think, see, the Honorable High Court judge has categorically stated that government has not produced enough evidence, not even no evidence actually, he has written no evidence against those baseless charges they have put on me. They have slapped it and they just put it behind the bar and they forgot for 8 months. And we were like, okay, after Diwali you will get, after Holi you will get. Okay, after Chunao you will get. We were just waiting. Then that one day, that was enough. Then we thought that no, we have to hit the street. We have to come forward. And that then, and the break, you know, they say, wo back up gaya to jab Manish Bhandari ko jab bail mili. Maine kaha jisne oxygen band ki usko bail mil gayi. To main kyon hu? What did I do wrong? In few months, I was feeling guilty that maybe I have done something. Then I realized, what the hell? I said, no, I will write the letter, and you know, that was the one crucial point.
This was Dr. Kafeel Ahmad who said accountability should be fixed for those who are really responsible for it. There was a very important point he made, was the letter forwarded not only to the college management but higher-ups, which were ignored, just paperwork were done, and innocent children were dying, innocent children lost their lives. It is up to you to think about it, to question the system, who are really responsible behind this mess.